The DVLA choir will be reading the first poem today, which was written in 1822 by Clement Clark Moore and is called 'Twas the Night Before Christmas, also known as A Visit from St. Nicholas.
'Twas the night before Christmas when all round the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. A mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the lustre of midday to objects below. What to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer.
With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall, now dash away, dash away, dash away all.
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pouring of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow.
The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, to his team give a whistle,
and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight,
"Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
It's in the singing of the street corner choir. It's going home and getting warm by the fire. It's true wherever you find love, it feels like Christmas. A cup of kindness that we share with another, a sweet dream with a friend or a brother. In all the places you find love, it feels like Christmas. It is the season of the heart, a special time of caring.
It's like Christmas.
The next reading is a poem written especially for the event by Bronwyn John from the Contact Centre, The Honest Christmas Poem. If everyone is honest, nobody has the perfect Christmas.
It is always planned for, aimed for, but typically goes wrong instead.
It's fights over the Christmas lights that deserve to have the Mission Impossible theme played to untangle them.
It's the arguments over board games that makes you realise why they come out once a year.
It's the dry turkey you've struggled to make and equally struggled to swallow.
But you still manage to eat three helpings of Christmas pudding.
And the masterful, tactful avoidance of doing the dishes.
It's not enough chairs.
Is Die Hard a Christmas movie? Ensue World War III and occasional knocking over of the Christmas tree.
It's the swell of the music of the kids' Christmas choir and the one voice being unable to say Wences laughs on cue.
And you know in your heart of hearts that voice belongs to you.
But with every imperfection, a Christmas story is born.
For the summer of the soul is December, and though we strive for perfection, we end up second best.
There is nothing that can compare to that swell in your chest. The next song is the beautiful Christmas carol, O Holy Night, with a solo from Abigail Williams.
Oh, holy night, the star.
Christmas to me. The cold nip in the air and that tingle on your nose. The feeling of the cold mornings, fluffy socks to warm your toes.
The Christmas music playing everywhere you go and hoping that tonight was the night we'd have snow.
Watching something festive with a warm cup of tea, trying to make sure the dog doesn't destroy the tree.
It's the taste of mince pies and the smell of mulled wine. Your mum getting stressed but exclaiming, I'm fine.
It's the wishing of a Merry Christmas before you depart, feeling those words within your warming heart.
It's the smell of Christingle oranges as you enter the church, a circle of candlelight as you sing of Christ's birth.
It's hearing the organ play and the silver brass band, singing in the bar as we sway hand in hand.
It's fresh bed sheets and pyjamas as you tuck up in bed, thoughts of excitement as the pillow meets your head.
Wake up, it's Christmas, you hear excitedly, feeling a gentle shake as you sit up and say, okay, I'm awake.
You reach to your side and pick up your phone. It's still kind of early, but you don't moan or groan.
Merry Christmas wishes you send to the group. Then you open your next message and read, so do you want patty, prawns or soup?
An exchange of gifts in your pyjamas while sat on the floor. The gratitude overwhelms you. You could not wish for more.
It's a frosty morning walk and the crunch of grass, giving out Christmas wishes to those that you pass.
Entering home to a concoction of scents in the air, the clattering of dishes and the scrambling of chairs.
It's that beautiful chaos filling the room, along with the overwhelming smell of Grandma's perfume.
Crackers being pulled and jokes getting told. The sound of your loved one's laughter will never get old.
Turkey stuffing with all the trimmings piled high on your plate. Pigs in blankets, Yorkshire puds, and the gravy's always late.
It's piling into the living room to gather around the telly as you try to get your mind away from your extremely full belly.
The Prosecco's already flowing while the dishes are piled in the sink. It's fine, they can wait until later. Let's all have a drink.
It's festive anthems blasting as you dance around the tree, shaking Stevens, the Pogues, Slade and Brenda Lee.
Just pause for a moment and take it all in, and you'll find a warm feeling fill you within.
The day is over and it's time for bed, and you reflect on your day as thoughts fill your head.
Now Christmas 2020 may be different from others, the table feeling less squished, and FaceTime to see our brothers.
We can still be together, although we're apart.
Because the ones we love truly sit within our heart.
Thank you.
eyes and make a wish as you tie me to your wrist.
When my string begins to pray, you know your wish is on its way. For us to sing together again.
Lights, you're my flashlight.
Chimes of doom.